Guys, how are you? Hope you all are doing good. Myself Rahul Jain, and we are going to discuss very important MCQs as a mini mock test for the UGC NET and JRF exam computer science. So let's start. The very first question is minimal deterministic finite automata for the language L equals to 0 to the power n, where n should be greater than or equals to 0. But n doesn't equals to 4 will have. So the condition is that our language is given to us, which is 0 to the power n, means input element, input symbol is 0, where n should be greater than or equals to 0, but n should not be equals to 4. Okay, so this is constraints. Constraints is given to us in a language. And we need to find the minimum number of deterministic automata, minimum number of states in the deterministic finite automata. So if you know the concept of DFA, then we may have zero number of zeros as n does. We may have 0 to the power 0, or we may have 0 to the power 1, we may have 0 to the power 2, we may have 0 to the power 3, or we may have 0 to the power 5, but we don't have 0 to the power 4. Okay, so if I try to make an automata for that, then you can consider this state as a initial state. Suppose it is a Q naught. Then on input 0, I can traverse to Q1. It is also a final state, because if only one 0 can be accept, then this can accept one 0 only. Then again, I am taking Q2. So if two zeros are there in the language, it can accept it. Again, I am taking Q3. If three zeros are there in the DFA or in the language, it can accept it. Then I am taking Q4. But if four zeros are there, then it should not accept. So I am not making Q4 as a final state. And then I am taking Q5 as a final state, because it may have five zeros. But after four zero should not be there, but after that as many zeros should be there as many a user or you want. So you can say that how many states are there, q0 to q5, so total six states should be there. Out of which only one is non-final state, because it should not accept four zeros in the language. That is why we are getting five final states. Okay guys, so if you will try to make match it with the options, you will get option D is the answer. Five final states among six states. I hope it is clear to you. The next question is the regular expression corresponding to the language L, where L is equals to x belongs to 0, 1 asterisk x, where x ends with 1 and does not contain substring 00. So our language should be there. Our language is accepting the input elements 0 and 1. Our language is accepting the input elements 0 and 1. And condition is that it should always end with 1. But it should not contain substring 00. So let it solve by heat and trial method, because it is the best method to dequalify the options, incorrect options. So if I am going with option A, then you can say that one, I am taking one from here and I am taking one and zero from here. So it is ending with zero, but our language should always be end with one. So A is incorrect answer. Now option B. If I am choosing option B, then here my all language elements, all language will be end with 0 and 1. But our question is that it should always be end with 1, means 1 should be also be there, 1 all should also be there. But this kind of strings are not generating by this language, option B, because it is always ending with 0, 1. So it is also not the correct answer. Okay, option C, I am seeing option C is the correct answer, but for it I need to dequalify option D. So option D, you can dequalify it very easily, because suppose at initial I am taking 1 0 and string is there, so I can choose one more time, and this time I am choosing 01, and then I am ending it with 01. So you can say that double zero is there. It should not be there in the language, because the constraint is given that it does not contain substring 00. So it is not also the answer. So the C option is 101% the correct answer. So I hope guys you got the answer, got clarity. So guys, do subscribe our YouTube channel, press the bell icon button, like our video, and if you are facing any doubts or queries while solving question, do comment us. I will try to solve your all queries as early as possible. The next question is which transmission technique guarantees that data packets will be received by the receiver in the same order in which they were sent by the sender? So if you have the basic knowledge of computer networks, then you can say that broadcasting is out of context, because broadcasting is one sender is there and one sender is sending information to different receiver, for example DD News, isn't it? Unicasting is like one sender and one receiver, one sender is sending information to one receiver. Okay, one to one, it is one to one process, one to one, like face to face online interview. Packet switching is basically, suppose your information is there, then this information is broken down in several parts, and then this information is sent to the receiver. Okay, so it may be like, suppose packet 3 may be received first, then packet 2 may receive, then packet 1 receive, after that it will got sync, and then they will make in the correct order. But our question is that we need to send the information in exact the same order in which they were sent by the sender. So circuit switching is the concept in which receiver will receive all the packets in the same order as it is sended by the sender. So option D is the correct answer. Okay guys, the next one is which of the following control fields in TCP header is used to specify whether the sender has no more data to transmit? So finish, it will signify that there is an end of packet, there is an end of packets, or you can say that finishing the packet. So it will specify the user, the TCP header, that sender has no more data, and you can end the connection, right? RST basically it is used for reset the connection. Sync is used for synchronizing the data. Push is for pushing. So option A is the correct answer here according to the question. I hope you got the concept. The next one is which are two modes of IP security? So direct theoretical question, I hope you all know IP security, and which of the two modes of IP security? Option A, transport and tunnel, certificate and tunnel, pressured and transport. No, it is out of context. So transport and tunnel is the correct answer guys. Transport and tunnel are the two modes of IP security. The next question is the maximum payload of TCP segment is, what is the maximum payload of TCP segment? So you all know that the maximum TCP size may be 65535, isn't it? It is the maximum size of TCP segment. And you all know that the minimum size of TCP header should be 20 bytes, and maximum size of TCP header should be 60 byte, because 20 byte should be the minimum, it should be always be there, and the rest 40 bytes it is used as an option field, means you can add it. So if I remove this option field, then I can get maximum payload, because for maximum payload my size of TCP header should be minimum. So I can do it like 65 minus 40. So I will get 65495. It would be my maximum payload in a TCP. You know why I am doing minus 40 here? Because maximum size of a TCP header is 60 byte, in which 40 byte is for an optional purpose, option, is an option. But minimum size is a 20 byte. But the question is that what should be the maximum payload of a TCP segment? So for maximum payload, my header size should be, my TCP header size should be minimum. So I have subtracted this 40 byte because in this 65535, okay, in this 65535, you can consider it as a optional field. Means I need to basically what I need to do, I need to subtract it, subtract the value of IP header. I need to subtract the value of IP header, payload IP header from it. So option C is the correct answer here, guys. Option C is the correct answer. The next question is, in Java, when we implement an interface method, it must be declared as. So you all know that interface method should always be declared as a public. The next question is, adaptive maintenance is a maintenance which. So software engineering question. Option A, correct errors that were not discovered till testing phase. Option B, is carried out to port the existing software to a new environment. So option B is correct answer. Adaptive maintenance is a maintenance which is carried out to port the existing software to a new environment. So option B is the correct answer. It is the, basically it is a definition, option B, it is a definition of the adaptive maintenance. Okay, the next question is dining philosopher's problem. So operating system question, dining philosopher's problem is classical IPC problem for semaphores. Option B is the right answer. And the next one is WOW32 is a, actually WOW32, it is a special execution environment. Used to run 60-bit Windows application on 32-bit machine. So to run 16-bit Windows application on 32-bit machines, at that time, in the previous time, they use WOW32. Okay, so option D is the correct answer. So guys, I hope all the questions which I have discussed with you are clear to you. To get more mini mock tests from our side, you need to subscribe our YouTube channel. And guys, please show your response so that at least we can get the idea that whether you are liking these sessions or not, whether we can go for more sessions like that or not. So it is all depend on you. So guys, do subscribe our YouTube channel, hit the like button and share it with your friends. Have a very, very nice day, guys. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.